How may I help you? Ah, I see. So, are you in for a purchase? Okay. This is 25. This down here. Wouldn't want any one of these diamonds to. As I suspected, this is a fake. Beautiful, aren't they? Hello there. This is a walk-in, correct? I don't have a booking for this hour. No. Okay. Yeah, of course. Please, have a seat. I just need a moment to finish this. Are you in for a purchase, to sell, or to exchange? Likely to exchange, but possibly just to sell. You're curious to know what's on the market? Okay. So, would you mind showing me what exactly it is that you've brought in for me to take a look at today? Thank you. Ah, yes. Wow. Is the box for sale? Not the box. Yes, well. It is Hermes after all. And it seems to me, based on the quality of the box, just overall look of it, correct. The gold lettering, red finish. This does look to be a true Hermes. So, what do we have here? A few boxes. Do you mind if I just pour it all onto my working space? Thank you. Just gently place these. just quickly taking a very, very quick glance. They feel legitimate. But I will have to run a series of tests to get a better idea. You picked the right place to come here for these. How did you hear about us? Well, I'm glad my reputation precedes me in the best way. Right. First, I'm going to do a quick eye test. Just right. I'm looking to get a better visualization. The naked eye cannot quite spot any potential imperfections in any fraudulent diamonds of high quality. So, I have a set of lenses. So, with my lens, I'll definitely have a better idea. Wonderful. Let's take a look. Do you mind telling me where exactly you found these? Okay. So, in your attic, mysterious box. Interesting. Well, let's start with the diamonds first. Yes. Get a better look. Yes, this is a UV light to get a better look. It points out more of the scratches that you might find. Interesting. Beautiful cut. Definitely. Very well made. As of now, it doesn't have any scratches. Let's see. Will I test all of them? Nearly, yes. I just... Here is the problem with fakes. Sometimes you have fakes that are so well done that they seem real, and amongst them, when you have this many, you might find a mistake on one or two, or even sometimes you'll have a few real ones and then a few fakes to to kind of up the value. So I do need to go through all of these, okay? This will take time. I hope you'll be patient. Based on my first assessment, I will be quick to go through them. One got away there. Yes. I may need a little bit more light if I'm to really make sure that this is authentic. Never seen a pile this large of what seems to be so far real diamonds. Where is it you said you found this? In the attic? May I ask, is this an old home? Or... yes, you just moved in. And who was the last proprietor? Interesting. I always thought that woman was crazy. I suppose they didn't go through her things before selling the home. Her grandkids wanted to get rid of it as quickly as possible. That might have been their loss. And your gain. Well, the way I see it, all of these so far have been real. That is, let's count. 14 of them. I'm happy to do it, don't worry. I don't mind how long it takes. It's more for you. But if I were you, I wouldn't take your eyes off me. This is a real treasure. Wouldn't want any one of these diamonds to go missing. Last one. Okay. So let's just turn this off. Right. So from what I could tell, these all seem authentic. I did have these three. Can you see them? Yes. These three I have some doubts about, which makes me, of course, question the entire pile. This is a little bit, questionable. This here, I will test further if ever I do find something that is more, worrisome, that might lead us to doubt. I will test our entire pile here, okay? So, I will do a scratch test with these three. And I have this little pointed tip. You see this tool here? Yes, well, it's meant to just scratch and... I shouldn't be able to see anything. Diamonds being, of course, the toughest out there. I do have one more test to run. If they all turn out to be inconclusive, you might have yourself a real loot of diamonds. What? Kidding. Okay. Nope, nothing so far. Let me just... Yes, this last test is a polish that, as you can see, I'm just filling in the scratches that might appear now. If I were to take a look now, let's see. In the light, let's see that. Yes. Right, so if there's the smallest scratch, this polish would start to shine through the diamond. Well, the faux diamond. It's a very curious procedure indeed. Very helpful to discern reals from fakes. Okay. Well, it seems to me these are all true diamonds. Give him a quick count, shall we? Ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. You have 53 of these, I'd say, thumb-sized, thumbprint diamonds. That is impressive. Now for the pearls. I assume it'll be the same here. My little light. Tough to find. There we go. And, ooh, yes, the natural shapes. Pearls are so spectacular, aren't they? Well, this right here. You see the size of these little ones? This right here is much larger. It's our mother pearl. And it is authentic. Shall I place these back into the box? Yes. Gladly. Such a large treasure, You understand that we're going to have to go through the bank for this. Yes. I will be unable to buy these from you directly. Will you allow me to quickly call? Verify a few things? So, I'll just bring this over here. Gonna be a 30-minute wait, minimum. You know what? I won't make you wait that long. How about I have my assistant call them instead? Yeah, this'll take too long. Yes, I'm going to need you to make a phone call to the bank. Mm-hmm. No, not a personal one. This is going to be through... Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. For the business. I have a lady in front of me. She would like to sell 53 sizable diamonds. How sizable? An inch each. Oh yes, quite impressive. I don't care what it takes. I don't care how long the wait. You're going to get through to them. As soon as you do, you put them through to me, okay? It might take a while. That's okay. You'll stay on the line, Margaret, okay? Good. I'm depending on you. All right. Don't worry about her. She'll take care of it. But let's move on to the next items that you had. See here. So, did this come from the same place? No. This is your own collection. Okay. Two in one, I get it. Two birds, one stone. Okay. Let's see this. This right here just looks like a real pearl. Yes, it is. A real pearl. And the gold appears to be real as well. Here I have some silver, more gold with a tiny studded diamond in the middle, potentially, and a gold dolphin. Okay. So this is just a solution that I'm going to use on the gold, okay? So for gold, we use nitric acid to verify just how strong the gold is, or if it is indeed gold to begin with. So I do believe all of these to be gold. I will tell you which of these is the strongest. Now, let's just start with the dolphin. So the dolphin here, I'm just doing a slight scratch again. And we're going to apply a drop of the nitric acid. And just need to reach over here. So we're going to wipe it down. I don't need much of it to see. Okay. We'll get back to this in a few moments and repeat the same procedure. So on a chain, it can be a bit more difficult. Just going to drop there and proceed to wipe this down. And lastly, on the back of this rose, just a small scratch, and drop and pat it in so that it's fully absorbed. Going to leave that there, and it's going to just dry out. For the silver, I must say, just from the feel of it, it doesn't feel real. It's quite flimsy. And if I take a quick glance at the attachment piece, that's it. That's where you get the best idea of its quality. There's discoloration, even within the chain, ever so slightly. A good fake, yes, but not great. How long have you had that piece? Okay, yes, it's normal that by that point the discoloration is minimal if you've taken good care of it. However, you'll see in a few more years that it will, unfortunately, just kind of lose its shine. Next, we have a pouch. Right, so, same thing here. And I'm going to let that sit out here. This is quite a curious piece you have here. Yes. This is a leaf, am I correct? It's... I can't quite see the shine of it. Interesting. What a gorgeous, gorgeous piece. I must say, all your jewelry is tangled, and that's a sign of neglect for a jeweler. Next time you enter a jewelry store or a pawn shop, make sure to untangle them before. It's a bit insulting. I need a closer look. Right. This piece is a real leaf coated in gold. Coated rather in multiple metals, which gives it its sturdiness, since gold itself is quite malleable. I'm curious to know what metal lies under the coat of gold, but It's very sturdy. The chain itself, gold. 18 carat would be my guess, but we can test this too. Oh, you'd like to keep this one. I can see why. It's a good choice. I'll give it back to you in your pouch. So, we've done these. This is the last box, am I correct? Curious. These are cat pearl earrings, I take it? Ah, too young for you. I understand that. It is a very youthful design, made for children, I'd imagine, much like your dolphin. It's very cute. But yes, I could see how you would want to get rid of it now. And let's look. Slightly curved. Not a perfect pearl. Beautiful indeed. Beautiful gift for a young girl. Are you certain about wanting to get rid of this? Okay. Well, I think this would make a great gift. So, let's take a look now at these pieces. As I suspected, this is a fake. Mm-hmm. Much like this chain, this one is a fake. So, I don't think these will be much... will be worth much, rather. I'll let you keep those. Now, let's take a look. So, based on the reaction level, I would say this is 14 carat. Yes. It could give you a number for this. Yes, okay. So, this next piece. Bit flimsy, very thin. Very real, but not much material. I would say... Also, could sell it. I would buy it for a price. This one, now this is a beautiful piece. Again, knotted. The clip seems slightly damaged. That will, unfortunately, cost a little bit. But overall, a good piece. So, let me see. I'd like to give you a price for these items. Just need my pen. Let's see. What do you think would be a fair price? Have you gone anywhere else before? Okay. I guarantee you, anywhere that you may go for this flimsier chain, they will not give you a good price. Yes, even though the stone in the little flower is a diamond, they won't give you much. The dolphin, like I said, it's just coating. This piece, however, would have been very valuable. The buckle would require a replacement, which is work and labor. So anywhere that you go, I doubt they'd give you a better price than... this. What are your thoughts? Take your time. Okay. Listen, I'll be honest with you. It's not worth my time to do more for those. The diamonds are worthwhile. I'm just doing you a favor with those ones. So, fine, I can do you this. That is my final offer for this bit. Frankly, if you say no to my offer, the diamonds, you're going to struggle to find a good deal elsewhere too. And you're going to struggle to find someone who's going to be honest about it. My reputation is what it is for a reason. I am fair. But I take high cuts. And that is because I will treat your jewelry very well. And I know its value. So we can agree on the price. Perfect. The diamonds now. This is what I believe the bank will set that for. I assume you needed quick cash, otherwise you would have gone directly to the bank yourself, and that takes a lot longer than if you have a license like me. So, I think this many zeros will be satisfying to look at. Keep in mind, this was not your treasure first, and if you go through the bank, you'd have to explain how you found them. A whole legal battle might ensue. I think that this is your best. Shall I keep this? Okay. Let's put it aside then. Along with these remaining items. I just want to tidy this up a little bit. And are you signing off on it? Wonderful. You made the right call. This is the initial paperwork. The This is the initial paperwork. We will file a legitimate deal afterwards, but I do need you to sign here so that I can confirm with the bank. Of course. So you're just going to sign here. And wonderful. That will be sent to you. It will be forwarded to you. I just need you to go meet with Margaret in the other room. She is going to finish off and finalize the paperwork. So the final paperwork will be done shortly, as soon as all that information is sent to her. You don't have to worry. Those little babies will be in good hands. Great. Is that everything you wanted to show me? Were you looking for something? Yes. You did mention how the pearls were a bit young. I think I have something for you. Let's see. So, this is my set of pearls that I have. Beautiful, aren't they? All perfect pearls. I think you'll see that the amount I've offered you for those diamonds, with that, this is a very affordable piece. And once you receive the entirety of the payment, you will be nouveau riche. And you'll need to start dressing as such, I think. This piece would definitely complement your look. You'd look more ladylike. It's a stunning, stunning piece. Very classic but unique, with a matching pair of earrings. What do you think? Okay. Not today then. You want to secure the payment first. That is a wise financial decision. I don't blame. Well then, I thank you for coming in. I'll let you find your way back to the front, speak with Margaret. You may have to wait till she's off the phone with the bank. They've yet to call. Wonderful. Thank you so much for coming in. You made the right choice. And have a wonderful day.